All right, let's take a look at 1039 North Exeter here. Three bedroom, one bath property. It's completely turnkey. It's got a basement, pretty much a full basement, which we'll take a look at. The ability to have that as an extra room, etc. Our kitchen here has been updated. The cabinets are in good condition. The only appliances are a refrigerator and a range in here, but there is definitely space for a dishwasher if you wanted to configure it a little bit differently. And then we've got a little space here for an eating area, which is nice. Our washer and dryer, which is typically here in this configuration of home, is actually down here in the basement. We'll show you that in a minute. Three bedrooms here and one bath, as I said. Our one bath, it's a fairly small three-piece, but it's adequate. It's in good condition. Nothing remarkable, nothing real concerning about it. We'll start off with the smallest of the three bedrooms. It's a nice feature here. We got a little built-in shelving, etc. But it is definitely a small room, quite small, but would still work. Certainly for as a kid's bedroom or in a rental that was splitting up by room. Our second bedroom here, smaller closet shared there. This right here looks like a laundry chute of some sort. It definitely goes down, as you can see, into the basement. And then our third bedroom here, little bit larger closet, so not bad. Again, the bedrooms, carpets, the rest of it is wood flooring. We've got tile style flooring in the kitchen and the bathroom, all in good condition, redone, etc. Head down here into the basement. Like I said, it's a full basement, it's very dry, it's in good condition. Right now it's really just suitable for storage. Certainly not anything livable over here on this side. Here's your washer and dryer hookup. The water heater looks relatively new, and same with the furnace. It's definitely got some, it's been taken care of. But you can take a look here. It's in pretty good condition, externally speaking. I wouldn't be surprised if everything else is in good condition. This area here is an opportunity. It's got some tiled flooring that they put on it here. I think it's a rubberized flooring is what it feels like. Good space. It's dry. It's got lights in here. It's not going to be considered livable space. It's not heated. It's not cooled. But it is dry. It's nice and definitely usable for additional, you know, maybe a gym or a rec room or something along those lines. But just overall, the house is really in good condition here on the inside. So let's go take a look outside real quick here. Yard's in pretty good conditions. Nice street here. Our driveway is, you know, a gravel driveway that goes towards the back. So no garage, at least from the front entrance. There is a an outbuilding in the back here. Condition wise, there's some, the paint on the wood here is chipping a little bit. So probably want to look at some resurfacing of that. It is the original windows in the house, as well as these storm windows that are out here. Got a nice, good-sized backyard for this area of the city. Just see if we can open this up. There we go. You know, one of the challenges of this house is that we don't have really a back door on the property. It's that side entrance over here. So that's something we want to make sure that we're taking note of. So maybe a different type of fencing arrangement so you could have access, better access to the back of the property. But condition wise, it's similar back here. Let's take a look at this structure in the back. It's quite large, so it's would be usable as a garage. Our alleyway is completely accessible, which is really nice, especially in this neighborhood. As you can see, the garage is not an overhead garage door. It's your standard barn pull door and everything. So either using it as it is would be fine, or certainly manual, or you could install a overhead at some point if you wanted to. But condition wise in the exterior, we're pretty good. No real huge red flags as we're looking through the property. So let us know what you think. Thanks.